you could see the big exhale from Vetrano when he scored that goal, and a great job by Dallas Aikens to get him out there, give him that opportunity. You want your guys rolling, and for Vetrano, he's a goal scorer. He likes to put the puck in the net.
Ryan off the board, shot and goal from Darnell Nurse. I'm not sure Dostal ever saw it. It may have been tipped.
And this is just getting that puck to the net quickly now. Edmonton's done a nice job early in this game at getting the puck in behind, establishing that forecheck, and you're going to see it deflect off of Comtois in the high slot as he goes down to try and block this. It just ticks off him a little bit.
And now Draisaitl burrows his way inside for McDavid. Backdoor, one-timer, and somehow that stayed out. Hyman can't believe it. McDavid barreling down the slot, trying to give him a second look, a third look, a save made, Dostal. Relatively low event first period. Shots just 6-4. It's not been wide open. Here's an opening. As I say that, McTavish one-timer score, and Anaheim ties it. It's the veteran Sam Carrick with his first goal of the entire season.
And this is a transitional play. Edmonton going for a change here. This puck's dumped in, and as it's chopped up the wall, it's held in. And that play right there, it's a great play to walk around, and Carrick is kind of left alone. After this play, he just kind of comes in back door. You can see him stick tapping right there for that puck to present the target to McTavish, and he puts it right on the tape, and this game is tied.
McTavish centering pass to Henry Fowler. McTavish. Fowler, a one-timer score, and the Ducks have their first lead of the afternoon. Cam Fowler with his fourth of the year. And I believe that's just his second goal ever.
Just a nice little back pass. Go down low first. They try that one. It doesn't work. And they just stay with it. A little give and go. Watch this back pass from the flank. McTavish again is going to pick up the primary assist, because I think this goes directly in through traffic. I'm not sure it tips. Maybe Henrique in the front was certainly right there. It did take a little chop at it the backhand side. But it's the quick.
Putting the brakes on, Draisaitl fires a pass, Kulak a drive, and that shouldered aside by Dostal. 2 minutes to go, what a move on Vetrano by McDavid to the net, and he put it off the goalpost, high in the air, right to Draisaitl. Only three times this year, and one of those came Thursday, has Anaheim actually led a game after the first period. Here's McDavid, trying to throw it in front, buried in Nugent Hopkins, shot, save, Dostal. Louis, do I need to send you up there to straighten everything out? Rigside, he'd have an official 9-game point streak. He has scored in each of the last 9 games he's played at least a point. 5 goals, 15 points, including his first hat trick, a steal by Derek Ryan. Holloway to the net, denied, Dostal, and he'll cover. Cuts in on Niemelainen, Klingberg's open, circles the net, gives it up, Fowler, with Terry calling for it. Loading, dishing, quick shot, Vetrano, and a save, Skinner, rebound kept alive, Vetrano. 12 times they've lost by at least 3 goals. Troy Terry to Kulikov. Terry steps in, shoots, and a glove save, Skinner. You don't run into many little kids named Lloyd, though. Open, Bouchard. Oh, take it away, and we've got a breakaway. Ryan Strom in on Skinner, scores! 3-1 Ducks.
One-handed stab, watch this. As this play comes back to Bouchard, takes some ice to the middle, tries to go back to Nugent Hopkins, and right there, the one-handed knockdown by Strom. He's in all alone, picks his spot. Over the pad, under the glove, is Stuart Skinner. And it's 3-1 for the Ducks. Just a good read by him. Looks up, knows he has time. Boy, was he ever poised walking in on that one.
Veteran guile of Ryan Strom. Puljujärvi with Nugent Hopkins in Janmark. Centering pass Janmark. That skipped wide of the mark. A blast by Barry. Blockered out to the point. Dostal, Niemelainen. Shot blocked by Megnin. Quick chance for Janmark, closed off by Dostal. Now McDavid snares behind the net. Plowing right through Shattenkirk, hard to the hole, dishes off, it's still loose. Piled up, crowd reacting, it never crossed the line. Nugent-Hopkins to Bouchard, and now McDavid in front to Clyde Hyman. Drysdale. Beautiful move. Set up McDavid. Deflected. And out to the end by Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. 3-2.
Ducks have been battling hard, especially on the penalty kill. Breaking up some plays. That cross pass right there doesn't miss Hyman by much, and Draisaitl puts it right back in the mix. Pinballs around, but eventually it's Nugent Hopkins that's able to put this home. And he's trying that little shot pass again, looking to Hyman, then it pinballs off a two Anaheim Duck, skates right to Nugent Hopkins. That's what happens when you have a presence in front of the net.
Oh, I guess I better throw it to Louis and Jack.
Yeah, he hesitated there, right?
He did.
He wanted to stay with that talented individual on the panel.
McDavid, Nugent Hopkins, McDavid, Drysdale. One-timer Barry and a save, Dostal. Big hop on the rebound. Benoit can't get there, McDavid will. 15 seconds on the 5-on-3. Drysdale peering inside. In front, and McDavid ties it.
This one's going to stay in the back of the net. And here's a good recovery once again. The Anaheim Ducks very aggressive on the penalty kill, but Edmonton just continues to overload. Come up with that loose puck, put it in the hands once again. And just a beautiful pass by Drysdale. Once he has this puck on his stick in a stationary position, he can pick whoever he wants to go to, and he threads the needle right to 97 into the back of the net. Good pickup by McDavid. Great finish.
Power play down to 15. Here's Nugent Hopkins. McDavid in front. Couple of taps. Hyman trying to jam it home. Others think it's in. But they wave it off. Lequier believes it was friendly fire that stung Drysdale. It's batted down on the launch the other way by Bouchard. Turned over. Strome. A wrist shot and a save made by Skinner. Rebound to Toronto. Louis, I think if Strome cuts left, he has a wide open path, and it doesn't matter. As from distance, Klingberg has his third goal in two games, right underneath the bar, and the Ducks regain the lead. It's 4-3.
Rim around the boards and just zinged it home, and right there, there's the first opportunity, and this puck, after this shot goes around, it's the non-stopping it right here by Klingberg. He just corrals that puck and whips it towards it. Bouchard inadvertently right here, right in the eyes of Stuart Skinner. Goes by him. If you're going to stand in front of your goaltender, you got to get in the way of that.
Here's McDavid looking to tie the game. Tracked by Kulikov. Swings it into the corner. Zegras lost the battle to Hyman in front. What a save! Dostal, a second stop! Right on the goal line with the leather!
And here it is here. Great first stride off the wall once he picks it up. The left pad, though, not once but twice. And then somehow Dostal's able to get the glove down and just hold on to it.
Not that you ever want to take penalties, but it's magnified. Here's McDavid. Short side in front. And what a chance for Yamamoto. Dostal able to hold sway and preserve the 4-3 margin. Anaheim looking for the upset. McDavid. Kicks it back to Tyson Barrie. Drysdale, a one-timer save, Dostal. Here's Nugent Hopkins, waiting, ditching. McDavid, one-timer, in front, deflected. And Ring trying to clear and hold, and he does. And Anaheim, behind 46 saves from Lucas Dostal, pulls it off, 4-3 over the Edmonton Oilers.